rap music have become familiar with the names of Fat Cat, Pappy Mason, and Supreme through the music of rappers like 50 Cent and Nas. You've read about these men in Queens Reign Supreme in various street and music publications. Now, for the first time, hear from the men themselves.
If you cop out and Pap cop out, we'll let your mother go. Mm-hmm. And give y'all 40, no more than 40, you know what I'm saying, in that ballpark.
And those who knew them best.
Basically, the Lorenzo, Fat Cat, Nichols, that's my pops, you know what I'm saying? And for the viewers out there that don't know, you know what I mean? Shit, he is who he is, you know? The true king of New York.
Who was the man in Queens in 1981?
I'd have to say Fat Cat, without a doubt. 1981, 82, 82,
he was the king. 83, he was definitely in there. 84,
Fat Cat, 85,
Fat Cat,
86,
Fat Cat,
87,
Fat Cat.
He made sure people ate, you know what I'm saying, spread the love.
As well as the numerous hip-hop figures they influenced.
Well, you know, man, the man on top of Queens is, of course, Fat Cat, man. He had Queens on lock, you know what I'm saying?
Anybody that was associated in that era of Edward Burns getting killed, anybody that was an associate of Pappy or associate of anybody that had anything to do with that killing, they are forever on the most wanted list.
Learn how the Edward Burns killing affected national drug policy and change the game forever.
The Edward Burns situation in Queens was the end of the crack era as we know it. It was the first time that anyone had openly assassinated a New York City police officer.
88 to the time Edward Burns got killed. Right around that corner, right here.
The way New York City looked at it is at the time they were so busy thinking about the mafia that they weren't paying attention to what was going on in Southeast Queens. They didn't, for lack of a better use of a word, they didn't give a shit. It was brought to everybody's attention throughout the city, so of course the upper echelon of the police department had to react, the mayor's office had to react, the governor's office had to react, and that's when they started creating task force.
I'm sorry, man, but South Jamaica created TNT. I'm real sorry about that shit, man. You know, I thought they was gonna disband that shit after they caught the people.
They started applying the RICO statute to the common drug dealer.
This is the story of how New York's most underrated borough set the tone for national drug policy while changing the face of pop culture. From Queens come Kings.
Out in the street, they call it
poor people are dead at random. Political violence can't done. Pure ghosts and phantom. The youth them get blind by stardom. Now the king of kings are called. Whole man to pick me. So why even no one if you with me? To see this operation sick me. Them suit no fit me. To win election them trick with them. Them don't do nothing at all. Come on, let's face it. I get our education's basic. And most of the youth them waste it. And when them waste it, that's when them take the guns, replace it. Then them don't stand a chance at all.
Let's go. Hey, yo.